Okay, we're going to attempt negotiation in Caladon. Our goal is to persuade Caladon government to basically become part of United Kingdom. We are basically ambassador of Tyrant, and our goal, me and my doggo, the doggo is here, we will be attempting negotiation together. I told all my clowns to wait, but doggo stays with me because it's faithful and good doggo, and I will not betray him. This is my contact here, Reynard. He will basically brief me for the mission. Greetings, madam. I'm Reynard. I have been expecting you. You are sent from Mr. Willem, will you see? No? Yes, Reynard. I'm here for the negotiation. Yes, yes, of course. You are, Reynard, loving his voice. You are not from Caladon. No, I hated this part. The pit of the vipers. Spit on the ground. I am a politician, and I know that sometimes the game is hard. But these Caladonians, I have never seen so much backbiting, boot licking in my all days. Interesting, do you have an advice? Yes, hold on to your wallet. So much money passes from hand to hand. Here I received bribe from beggars. Here, bless me. Here I have. He makes a sign across the across his breast, bowing his forehead. I pray to the gods that I survive this wicked place. Ah! Let's get to the point, Reynard. My apologies, madam. I just never had more terrible time, no matter. He stretches his god with him. You will proceed through these doors, straight ahead, through and to the large doors at the end of the inner courtyard. The guards there will be instructed to let you pass once we have finished our conversation here. And then, once through this door, you will walk directly to the end of the long hallway, to another set of large doors. Through these doors is the council. You will proceed to the podium, and the advisor will begin asking you questions. What's happened then? Once you finish the negotiation, you will obtain the signed agreement from them and leave the premises immediately. Mr. Willoughby will meet you right here with me once the negotiations are done. You will be paid then. Sounds clear enough. Some personal advice. You will no doubt be approached by not a few persons on your way to the advisor's chamber. There are individuals who will represent various interests here in Caladon, and will attempt to sway your position on the number of the point detailed in dossier you have received. So do not speak with them. Fuck them. Take no money from them. And for the love of God, do not change your position on any of the points. The very economic future of Arcanum hangs on the acceptance of Caladon into United Kingdom. Do you understand? Yes. Good day to you, Reynold. Good. I will send word to the guards to expect you. Good luck in the negotiation. I must depart. Okay. That was hard. Next. We are here. As you see, there are these vipers. Look how many of them they are. And this is a chamber of advisors. Let's give them some time. Human noble. You have trained by Kalnendri herself, weren't you? That's quite the thing. It is something to be proud of. May I ask you who you are, sir? I am Prince August Frad, heir to the throne of Ireland. Please forgive me, but you caught me in the midst of preparation. I am amazed by your overwhelming effeminate nature. Sometimes levity and bravery go hand in hand, but my patience runs these days. I forgot myself. Is there any work for one such as I? I'm very sorry, good miss, but today I have no time for the pleasantries. Perhaps later. Okay. Vipers, this is hard. They speak for very long. Okay, so we are ready to attempt negotiation at any point, but these people are important here. Human noble. Hello, Ter, do you have a moment to speak? No, I have to immediately go to advisor chamber. Are you sure I might be advantageous for you here? What I have to say? Well, perhaps a few moments. I knew to be an individual of good judgment. I represent Department of Transport in Caladon. How can I help? I know you are a way to speak with the advisor. Caladon to the advisor. I just like to tell you that if I can get a signed agreement that states that Caladon will have the rights to build and own her railroads, we will be very appreciative. Just how appreciative, sir? 150 gold pieces, appreciative, he smiles, offering his hand. If you do so, return here and we'll complete the transaction. I will take it under advisement. I will wait here after you've spoken with King Advisor. Greetings, madam. Could I ask you for a few moments of your time? Of course. Thank you. Thank you very much. I understand the position you are in, and I won't be long at all. I'm the representative from Department of Treasury here in Caladon. Greetings, madam. How can I help you? Oh, it's you. I've been briefed that they had chosen the other fellow. Your abilities is setting price aren't what we consider favorable to this negotiation. I'm afraid we are nothing further to talk about. Yes, so basically because my abilities are not to the pair with their expectations, she don't even wanna bribe me. Greetings, madam. Do you have a moment of time? No, I have to immediately go. Oh, shame, madam. I'm sure you do be quite interested in what I have to say. Well, perhaps a few moments. I seems Tarant had chosen representative as well. A good negotiator must know all of the issues. I represent Magic Consortium here in Caladon. How can I be of service? Yes, I see you are the truly a friend of magic. It trans just influenced your city in United Kingdom. You can understand why users of magic might be concerned at the outcome of the negotiation. Of course, how may I help? Well, you need only make sure that users of magic are given special consideration and concession within the city walls. If this is outlined in the agreement, we'll be most happy to pay you a consensual fee of, let's say, 50 gold pieces, an interesting offer. This is garbage offer. I paid beggars more than he offered me. Hello there, madam. Could I spare a few moments, valuable time? No, I have to go to advisor's chamber. Are you quite sure, madam? I have no doubt that this meeting will be much really beneficial. Wait, I do have few minutes to spare. Your reputation precedes you, madam. You have heard great things about your abilities and your sense of discernment. I represent Committee of Technological Research in Caladon. Thank you for your compliment. How can I help? Oh, I thought you might be more technologically inclined, but that isn't the case. I don't believe we have anything left to speak about, madam. You just said that my abilities or something. Also, you have some... Greetings, madam. Do I wish to battle skirt? Might I impose you a few moments? Of course. Thank you. I will keep this brief and to point. My name is General Wells. I represent Caladon Military. Hello, General. How can I be at service? I can tell that you woman well versed at the ways of war. You might just understand our position here in the negotiation and perhaps be able to give us some assistance. Of course, how may I help? You are aware that United Kingdom requires that half of the troops of new members must serve under UN If yet, battalions, we understand this position, but we believe that Caladon needs to keep her standing army indefinitely. If you happen to agree and see that is become part of agreement, we do give you 2,000 gold pieces. The spoils of war. Thank you for stopping, madam. May we speak?
No, please, just a moment. And I will say what I need to say, all right.
I knew I could count on you, madam. I represent Caladonian Mint. I just wanted to thank you for being here and to say that it would be in everyone's best interest, but especially yours, if Caladon Gold will always be honored as equally as unified gold. You know, there are more concerns here than meet the eyes. He gives you long, solemn wink. How would you define best interest?
Will you be interested in... No, I will not. No, I will not, you piece of rat.
Human dweller, thank you for stopping, madam. May we speak? Please. Almost predatorily, she is quite beautiful. I'm so glad that you are making the time for me, madam. I represent Department of Trade Export here in Caladon, so maybe... I can think of many ways, but right now I think that it would be best serve everyone if we come to some sort of compromise on the issue of Caladonian shipping route. I believe that Caladon is entitled to charge a toll even to United Kingdom, maybe. Toll will be charged indefinitely. You agree, don't you? What benefits? 800. No, doesn't sound... That's intriguing. I will not get back to you. Madam, can we speak?
No, I must go to Advisor's Chamber.
Madam, we must talk, really. The future of this fine city, that of the United Kingdom, rests upon your coming to some sort of agreement. Very well, continue. Thank you, madam, for taking the time. I'm from Department of Labor. How can I help? You might be aware of growing problem with labor union in Tarant. You are bringing production efficiency down and driving manufacturing cost up. We can't have that happen here in Caladon, madam. We need the labor unions to be outlawed here. I believe that we can convince you of the compelling nature of agreement. How you plan to convince me? Half Orc Villager. Hello here, madam. Just a minute of your time. Of course. Young Department of Agriculture, how can I help? As you doubtless see, our Tarant and much of the United Kingdom is dependent upon Caladonian farming for grain and other food production. Because of this, our farmers make a very nice living, and our economy is very stable. Our food export taxes and tariffs bring in considerable amount of money. We need to make sure this continues to be the case. If you can assure that the grain taxes will be kept in place even after membership, then I'm sure we have 600 gold, no thanks. Hello, madam, could I speak? Of course. You are true lady, madam. I won't take much of your time, precious time. I'm a member of Caladonian Parliament. How can I help? As you know, Caladonian is a monarchy, but we do have elected parliament with limited power. We also understand that United Kingdom has a parliament and that each member has a criterion number of votes based on size of seniority. If we could persuade you to our ways of thinking, you feel that Caladon should have 4 votes from the very beginning. We realize that this is the same number as Tarant, but we need to look at the importance of United Kingdom of powerful kingdom like Caladon. If you agree, I can make sure that this gets in the agreement, then we can make sure you are given 900 gold pieces. Perhaps I will consider it. And let's start negotiation. You need to interact with the podium. You can't talk to these people. Dear madam, we are grateful for your time today and would very much appreciate a few moments of your time to clarify the remaining points in the article of membership. Once you have answered our question, then we will vote as to what our position will be concerning Caladon membership in the United Kingdom, please. Okay, so Tyrant will control our railroads. Please specify that Tarant's position will be on an issue of construction of railroad here in Caladon. This is like most idiotic choice. It's, why it's okay. On subject of magic and its use within the city, I would like to give mages special privilege because I am mage. But I think it doesn't give anything substantial, even. Yeah, it will not change coding of the city, it will not be. Mm-hmm. We must forget old ways and focus on technological age. I work for Bates. Bates is genius. His triadrum assures Caladon prosperity. What will happen to our army on Navy? So they want that half army of Navy will serve in unitized battalions. Whatever it means. This is like in agreements. Mm-hmm. Full change bit cells of commonality. Shipping route. Free use of shipping route build. A stronger economy for all. And that's true. Outlaw. Mm-hmm. The seniority must prevail. They wanted to start from 4 votes, same number of votes like Tarant, which is 4. We must share everything for prosperity that includes grain. This greatly benefit Tarant as it's only importing import from here. So this will make Tarant powerful to have grain in shared commodity without tax. Thank you. Wait. Yes, thank you. Oh, I supposed to read all this. We have good save. I consider now if I get the best possible reward if I send half of the army. This kind of interest me, how many alteration I can take from this road. You have to wait, because now a scene is reloading and this guy Reynald is disappeared from here and he told me he will wait here, so his waiting is kind of lie. Of course, here it is. Incredible, you are exceeded even our highest expectation. Bravo, it's a lot. Effort, usually honorable ambassador, people shall always remember that you have done here today. Well done, madam. Mm-hmm. You have to give answers that doesn't subject you to single bribe. Tarant control everything. Forget old ways. Bates freedom. And there is half of the army. This is like best outcome to give half of the army. This is what they want. This is shit, the heavier tax, like what the fuck. And what representation that all United City members must discontinue use of their own currencies. An immediate and full change builds a sense of commonality. And what shipping route? Free use of shipping routes builds stronger economy for all. And this is true even for Caladon. This is not only like, you know, like Caladon lose on this in initial time, but because they will have outlived union labors, they could potentially outproduce Tyrant and possibly gain advantage in economical field. So yes, initially it's worse for Caladon, but we'll see later. What labor union? Caladon is better protected if labor union are outlived. Yeah, so seniority, share everything. Okay, yeah. So this basically gives you best rewards possible. You can also dismantle Caladon army, but that's waste of good, well-trained soldiers and useless. You should not do it. Especially since you don't know what happened to these soldiers once they are dismantled. It's not easy to just, you know, fire everyone. Here, thank you. Yeah, so we became Persuasion Master and Honor Ambassador. In that order, we also gave him away this sheet. Yes, and I did wonderful job. So, thanks for watching.